ya ngai wakwa
kuwe mwathani
ngoro yakwa ni gutera ngoro yakwa ni gukwambararia ugu
ngoro yakwa
ni gukuinira
tware wewe mwonane utugi waku we mwathani utũraga tene na
ngoro ĩno yakwa
ngoro yakwa nĩ gũkũinĩra
nĩ gũgũthathaia ngai wakwa
wĩ mũnene ũtugi waku we mwathani
ũtũraga
tene na tene
yakwa mararia ngoiga ngoro
yakwa nĩ gũkũinĩra
nĩ
ũndũ ũrĩa wĩ mũnene ũtugi waku we mwathani
ũtũraga
tene na
tene wĩ mwĩhokeku ngai wakwa
ngoro yakwa nĩgũkũinĩra
nĩ
ũndũ ũrĩa wĩ mũnene ũtugi waku we mwathani ũtũraga tene na tene
ngoro yakwa niĩ
ngoro yakwa nĩgũkũinĩra
ũmũthĩ
nĩ ũndũ ũrĩa wĩ mũnene ũtugi waku we mwathani ũtũraga tene na tene
ndagũthathaiya
ngoro yakwa nĩ gũkũinĩra nĩ ũndũ ũrĩa wĩ mũnene ũtugi waku we mwathani ũtũraga tene na tene
ndakwambararia Jehova
ngoro yakwa nĩ gũkwambararia
ũmũthĩ
ũtugi waku we mwathani ũtũraga tene na tene
ngoro
yakwa nĩ gũkũinĩra nĩ ũndũ ũrĩa wĩ mũnene ũtugi waku we mwathani ũtũraga tene na tene ngoro yakwa nĩ gũkũinĩra nĩ ũndũ ũrĩa wĩ mũnene ũtugi waku we mwathani ũtũraga tene na tene
ngoro ĩno yakwa mwathani today King of all glory I choose to bless you I choose to give you praises I choose to adore you I choose to magnify you somebody lift up your hands to the Lord worship him for a moment tell him my heart King of all glory is full of praises dear Redeemer about you for you deserve dear Redeemer all the worship you deserve all the praises from within me with everything that is within me dear Lord my voice dear Lord is saying my mouth is confessing King of all glory you are praises oh Redeemer there is none like you there is none like you in our camp there is none like you in our lives there is none like you King of all glory we celebrate you we adore you we honor you we magnify you oh dear master we adore you we exalt you we exalt you for who you are for what you have made us dear master today we thank you we honor you Jehovah there is none like you somebody worship the Lord somebody lift up your voice lift up your voice to the King of all kings even as we welcome them that are watching us online from wherever you are blessed be the name of Jesus Christ I welcome you join us as we magnify the name of the Lord join us as we celebrate the name of the Lord church let's celebrate Jesus for his faithfulness let's celebrate Jesus for his power and majesty let us celebrate Jesus for what he has done unto us oh thank you Redeemer thank you Redeemer thank you Redeemer shekete ribara zataya. Ropo seke riba shandelele boya zikata. O shandara bosika ramayando robo shekete rebo. Come on, somebody celebrate Jesus. Come on, somebody celebrate the Holy Ghost. Celebrate our Father. Oh, lift up your voice, lift up your hands to the Lord. Give him a mighty, 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 great celebration. Hallelujah. We adore you, we honor you. We thank you and we worship you for giving us yet another opportunity. King of all glory, to be gathered in your house. We are not taking it, King of all glory, for granted. We know it's a privilege, it is an honor from thee. Oh, Redeemer, thank you, for you have called us today. Oh, thank you, for you have enabled us today. Somebody, are you called? Are you called today? Have you been enabled? Lift up your voice. Tell the Lord, I am ready for the next move. I am ready for the next shift. I am ready, King of all glory, for the direction that you have ordained of us today. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we are ready, King of all glory, to repair the breaches. Somebody, we have been called as the repairers of breach. And that is what we'll be handling this evening by the grace of God. As we continue in prayer, I want us to have an understanding. We are not just praying, blessed be the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Amen. But we are praying from a place of understanding that the Lord has raised us. The Lord has given us this privilege. The Lord has enabled us. The Lord has called us into this honorable place where we can be able to cause changes, to turn things around. Hallelujah. Amen. Where we can be able to repair every mess and every kind of ruin in our lives. So I wanted to engage in that understanding. I wanted to engage in that understanding. Let's get out of the shadows that the enemy could have held you at. Get out of those shadows. Lift up your voice to the Lord. Lift up your cry to the Lord. Lift up your hands to the Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, as we wage war in the spirit, as we wage war in the spirit, as we wage war in the spirit, in the name of Jesus Christ, we are here to wage war. Come on, somebody. We are here to declare commands. We are here to declare that there must be changes. We are here to cause things to move in the name of Jesus Christ. Open up your mouth, regardless of what could be happening in your life or what could be happening around you. Refuse to stay there. Refuse to stay there. I'm calling you to a place that the Lord has lifted us to. I'm calling you to this place. Lift up your voice. Lift up your voice. Whether the hell has broken loose in your life or in your family, in your camp, somebody, you have been given a title of repairer. You have been called a repairer. So if there be issues that require some amendments, we are the right people. You are the right person. Woman, you are the right person. Man of God, you are the right person. Young person, you are the right person. You are in your place. Therefore, fold your hands well. Raise your shoulders high. And let us contend now with every kingdom that is working against us. With every force from hell that has raised itself against us. And declare things can never be the same again when we are around. Things can never be the same again when we are around. Oh, things can never be the same again when the Lord has anointed us. Things can never be the same again when we have been called. Yes, when we have been chosen. When we have been chosen. Remember, we were told on Sunday by our Father that we have been chosen. Not election, but chosen. Chosen, chosen. Now rise to your place in the name of Jesus Christ. Hey, somebody, ascend to the threshing floor. Ascend to the threshing floor. Let we knowing in the spirit take place. Let we knowing in the spirit take place as we separate the grain to the chaff in the name of Jesus Christ. As we separate good and evil, as we separate issues, oh, there must be a separation. There must be a separation. This mixture cannot continue to reign again in our lives, cannot continue to reign again in our churches, cannot continue to reign again in our families. In the name of Jesus Christ, we are the people by the empowerment of the Holy Spirit that are going to lift hands up. Oh yes, and by the blowing of the Holy Spirit, by the wind of the Holy Spirit, the chaff is getting out, the dirt is getting out, everything that is not of the right grain, it is getting out of the rear of the original. In the name of Jesus Christ, we thank you, our Father.
We give you praise,
we give you glory, we give you honor, we give you adoration. Oh, we celebrate you, we celebrate you, we celebrate you. Somebody, I want us to read the word of God so that we can be able to push to the next level. In the book of Isaiah, reading from chapter 5:8, Isaiah 58, and I want us to pay attention to verse 12. That is our key scripture. Come on, somebody. I'm smelling war. Hey, leo lazima mambo itendeke katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Are you feeling like me? Are you with me? Yes, we are here to cause things to happen in the name of Jesus. I've said Isaiah 58, reading from verse 12. In the name of Jesus Christ. And we can also see verse 6. Let's see verse 6. Not this, the first that I have chosen, to loose the bands of the wickedness. Somebody, I want you to lift up your voice and declare, I am here.
I am here
to loose the bands,
to lose the bands
of wickedness. To undo the heavy burdens.
To undo the heavy burdens.
And to let the oppressed go free.
And to let the oppressed
go free. Can I hear you? And to let the oppressed go free.
And to let the oppressed go
free. And that the yoke be broken.
And that the yoke be broken.
That's what we are doing today.
Hallelujah.
And that's why we are praying and fasting. Remember, we are in our third day of prayer festival. Blessed be the name of Jesus Christ. Can we get now to verse 12? Then we get to verse 12. And they shall be, of these shall build the old waste places. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Can we get a better version kindly? Amen. Let's read together. Some of you will rebuild the desert ruins of your cities. Then you'll be known as the rebuilder of walls and the restorer of homes. Can we get King James, New King James Version? There is something I'm looking for. Those from among you shall build the old waste places. Hallelujah. Those among us shall build the old waste places. Are there waste places in your life? Are there waste places in your family? Are there waste places in the body of Jesus Christ? Are there waste places, oh yes, in our county? When we say that we are going to rebuild those waste places, you cannot rebuild unless there was a construction that once existed.
Yes.
Blessed be the name of Jesus Christ. You cannot repair unless there was something that once existed. So when we talk about repairing, we are saying we are going to reconstruct it again. We are going to restore the wastefulness. Blessed be the name of Jesus Christ. The damage places, the damaged areas, those faulty areas in our lives, those are the ones that we are concentrating with, and that is level one now. Somebody, that is level one. I want you to engage now in the realm of the spirit and begin to pray. I want us to restore families that have been ruined. Remember, we are dealing with the ruined. We are dealing with the ruined. We want to see marriages stand. We want to see children all being raised by families that are well established. We want to see people praying again. We want to see altars of families standing again. I want you to raise up your voice and now begin to pray that things must be restored to their original form, their original way, in the name of Jesus Christ. The very first idea about marriage that the Lord had must be established in our families today, in the name of Jesus Christ. We refuse to have divorces. We refuse to have separations of marriages, in the name of Jesus Christ. When the Lord has anointed us, when the Lord has called us, we refuse to allow the enemy to continue taking an upper hand, in the name of Jesus. We are not ignorant of the enemy. We are not ignorant. We are not ignorant of the ruins that the enemy has caused in our families. We are not ignorant of the damage that the enemy has done. Somebody lift up your voice. Yes, maybe your marriage is working, but your neighbor's is not working. The person seated or standing with you, you may never know how they are faring. Lift up your voice and pray that it is going to be established. Oh yes, it is going to be established. Families are going to be established again. Children are going to enjoy the love of their fathers again. They are going to enjoy the love of their mothers again, in the name of Jesus Christ. There will be unity, chambers of unity, chambers of discussions, chambers of moving things in marriages and in families, in the name of Jesus Christ. Because we understand, when marriages, when families have not been able to stand, even the body of Christ will be affected. Somebody lift up your voice. Lift up your voice and declare an establishment. We raise them now. We raise them now. We raise them now. In the name of Jesus, we lift families now. We lift families now. Fathers, be restored to your sons. Oh, sons, be restored to your fathers, in the name of Jesus Christ. Husbands, be restored to your wives. Wives, be restored to your husbands. Children, be restored. Oh yes, we lift the family altars now. We raise the family altars, in the name of Jesus Christ. Families, we all pray together again. Families, we all worship together again, in the name of Jesus. The altars of worship, we establish. The altars of worship, we establish. Family altars, in the name of Jesus Christ. Somebody, I want you to pray for people. I want you to pray for individuals. I want you to pray. If you know them by their names, you can mention them. I want us to pray for the church, the people in the church, them that used to serve, and today they have stepped backward. The women who used to come early for devotions, but now they have stepped aside and they are watching things move. I want you now to get to that level. Yes, open up your mouth and declare. Oh, there is restoration. There is restoration, in the name of Jesus Christ. Women are restored today. Oh yes, men are being restored today into their places of worship, into their places of service, into their places of ministry, in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, shakarabo shekete, rodobo si karamashendeba. We are sepakarabo, yasokorobo shindarabaka, veporosoto koyandaba, reposika tarabo shenderebo, yazata karabo shindere. Aleluia. Oh, Redeemer, we stand in the gap. Oh, for that brother who was once a preacher. Oh, for that brother who was once an usher. For that brother who was once a keyboardist in the church. But today, he has played the same in the world. He has caught up in clubs. He has caught up in bars. We uproot them from those places. Come on, somebody remember. We are rebuilding. We are rebuilding the waste places. The waste places in the hearts of men. The places of worship in the men of God. That's why there is no passion anymore. That's why there is no agility anymore. That's why there is luxury. There is luxury. Come on, somebody. Let go for them. We travel in the realm of the spirit. In the bars of Kaguma. We travel in the realm of the spirit. In the bars of this county. And we call them by their names. Our brothers. Our sisters. It is your time. It is your time. To rise again. To rise again. To rise again. Come on, somebody. Can I hear you? Hey, Sharabaka. Ropo sekete yando lebizi kamaye ropo sikata ropo koshinda rabaye zekere mashanda rabosete. They must praise the Lord again. They must praise the Lord again. We will not allow in our camps people to sit down again who used to serve. Hey, we will not allow great worshippers to continue watching when them that are worshipping are continuing. Hey, it's time. It's time to bat their ministries again in the realm of the spirit. We have a responsibility, my brothers and sisters. Lift up your voice. Lift up your voice for somebody. Lift up your voice for somebody. Oh, the kamazokote. Ripa kashandarabo. Yaramazikate. Rekenderebo shikaya. Zatorobo sika. I want you to get to your home. I want you to get to your family. This time round, you know you are drunkard cousins. You know you are wasted brothers and sisters. Hey, you know you are auntie who is always visiting those people that call themselves witch doctors. You know them. You know them. Lift up your voice. We are must rebuild again. We are rebuilding those wasted places again. Oh, in the name of Jesus Christ. Hey, in the name of Jesus. No idol worship again in our families. Altars that are not godly. Altars that are not godly. In the name of Jesus. No more visitations of fake prophets. No more visitations of fake prophets by our people. We are establishing the order. We are establishing the order. And the order is we shall worship only the Lord God Almighty. In the name of Jesus Christ, we will not worship any other. We will not worship any other. We will not pay sacrifices of blood, of animals, of bulls, of goats to our dead fathers, to our dead grandparents. In the name of Jesus. Somebody refuse to have such kind of sacrifices being done in our families. Hey, for this to happen, we must call our great glad parent from his grave so that he can give authorization. Shame on you, Satan! It will never happen again. In the name of Jesus Christ, we are the generation that is creating a new order. We are the generation that is bringing a church. We are the generation that is breaking those systems. Oh, that is breaking those systems. That is breaking those cycles. Hey, for our sisters, for our brothers to live good lives. We are the people. We are the people. Systems must be broken. In the name of Jesus, systems must be broken. All structures that are satanic in our family lineage must be broken. In the name of Jesus, it is not going to continue again. Not when I am alive, not when I'm called a daughter in that family, not when the Lord has anointed me. Hey, in the name of Jesus Christ, oh, awesome puberty, we are demolishing you now as we raise the prosperity that was ordained of the Lord for us. My dear brother, my dear sister, I want you to understand, there is nothing that you are building now. You are only picking it. You are only picking it from where it was destroyed from and calling it back to life. In the name of Jesus Christ. Therefore, you need to change you. You need the energy of the Holy Spirit. I told you we are in a war. I told you we are in a battlefield. And this time round, we are not waiting for the enemy to make a move. We have decided to invade. We have decided to invade. I want you to confront. I want you to confront those family issues. Oh, I want you to confront who said you must be married 2, 3, 4 times so that the 5th marriage can stay. I want you to confront that now in the name of Jesus Christ. Raise your voice. Raise your energy in the name of Jesus. Oh, Sharaboko. Mazoko Robina.
Back on track in the name of Jesus Christ. Our sisters back on the divine track of God in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Can I hear you, somebody?
You must be fruitful again. I've said
this time round.
You must be fruitful again.
We are not going to wait
again
for that cycle to repeat itself again. We are not going to wait for the cousins to divorce all of them. We are not going to wait for this puberty to get now into our lives so that we can arise. We are confronting, we are invading that camp of the wickedness, and we are telling the enemy, let go our people, let go our brothers, let go our sisters, let go our parents, let go our people. In the name of Jesus Christ, when Moses went to Pharaoh to let go the children of Israel, Pharaoh had a condition. Pharaoh had a condition. I will allow the people to go, and even the little ones. But these are the things that must be left behind. And Moses said, we are going with everything that is called by us, including the hoofs of our animals. We are leaving behind nothing. Come on, somebody. Refuse to allow conditions from the enemy. Refuse to allow ultimatums from the enemy. Rise in your place. We are taking them all. We are taking them all. We are taking them all. In the name of Jesus, tunaenda na wao wote katika jina la Yesu. Hatuachi, hatuachi, hatuachi. In the name of the Lord, in the name of the Lord, even though they are robbers, they are our people. Even though they are prostitutes, they are our people. Even though they are witches, they are our people. We raise our voices before destruction reaches them, and we declare
There must be a turnaround. There must be a church. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Somebody, I want you now to pray for the church. I want you to pray for the church. I want you to raise your voice and declare there will be true worship in our churches. There will be true gospel in our churches. We all have men of God who are anointed of our God, not anointed of something else, not anointing from hell, not anointing from any other source, but from the Lord. Oh, we are Kasoma Robinakate, Robozi Kataraboseke, Yandora Zika Rabayata, Reposi Karaboshendeba, Yandarabazikata, Repokozekete, Yazoko Roboshandaba. There will be morning devotions again. There will be ranch hours again. Oh, there will be cashers again. There will be revival meetings again. There will be crusades again. In the name of Jesus. Hey, there will be fellowships again. In the name of the Lord. We are the repairers. Somebody repair. Somebody repair. Something must stand today in our churches. In the name of Jesus. Something must stand again in our churches. Oh, the days of miraculous must return. Oh, the days of miraculous must return. We refuse to operate casually. We refuse to operate without signs and wonders in our churches, in the name of Jesus Christ. For we are called of the signs and wonders. The Lord must manifest whatever replaced the power of God in churches, whatever replaced the passion of God in our churches, we are demolishing you now. We are demolishing you now. We render you powerless. We render you powerless. And the men of God are free. They are free to operate in spiritual giftings. They are free to operate under the influence of the Holy Spirit. Oh, in Amakayato, Zekerebo Shikaraba. We open the doors of our churches. Oh, for miraculous. We open the doors of our churches. Oh, in the name of Jesus Christ. Hey, for greatness. Oh, somebody get tired. Get tired. Get tired. Of that same, 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 same. Structure. Oh, that same, 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 same way of worship. Hey, raise your voice. Hey, tell the enemy, vacate from our churches. Vacate from the churches of Kirinyaga. Vacate from the churches in this region. We refuse to buy your deception. We refuse to buy your deception. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hey, shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Can I hear you say a hallelujah?
Hallelujah.
Hey. Kasomarabo sheketa. Can we get back to Isaiah 58? Hey, in the verse of 12. Inamazoko robo shatabaye. After we have built the old waste places, you shall raise up the foundations of many generations. I want you to lift up your voice and raise foundations. Raise foundations. Now you can build what you want to see. Now you can speak for that which you want to see. Reign in your life. Reign in our churches. Reign in our families. As we have prayed for them. In accordance to the way we have prayed. We have prayed for churches. We have prayed for individuals. We have prayed prayed for our families. Now I want you to get back and raise those godly foundations. Rebuild again. Build again. Speak. Oh, Rakashenderebo Sikata. Ropo Siketerebo. Shandaraba Sikayata. Ropo Koshindarabayantele. Yandarabo Sikaramayando Bosokoteba. We raise the foundations of the fear of the Lord in our families. We raise godly foundations in our marriages. We raise godly foundations in our churches. Oh, we stir up an anger, a hunger for God. We stir up a hunger for God upon men and women in our lives. In the name of Jesus Christ, foundations of godly leaders must be established, that our great, great grandchildren, oh, we all have something to follow. We all have something to hold on to. In the name of Jesus Christ, I raise a foundation of worship. Oh, yes, the psalmist of grace will not end with me. In the name of Jesus Christ, I raise it now. I establish it now in my generations. In the name of Jesus Christ, and it shall be a godly legacy where the coming generation, oh yes, we will dress and tear. Our grandma Susan Chogu was a worshiper. No wonder we are worshiping this way. No wonder we are praising this way. Somebody raise foundations of God. Raise godly foundations in the name of Jesus Christ. Let there be altars of greatness. Altars of greatness in the name of Jesus.
A people that are seeking you, Lord, in the day, in the night, in the evening, dear Lord. Them that are walking in the light of the gospel, them that are walking in the understanding of the word of God.
Our children will serve the Lord in the name of Jesus Christ.
Oh, we bless
the young generation in our churches. Oh, Redeemer, we will learn to serve you. Obedience of your word. Oh, Redeemer is lifted again. We raise foundations of godliness. Oh, yes, Lord. Oh, yes, Lord. Oh, yes, Lord. Have mercy. Let them be established in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, godly ordinances in the name of Jesus. Oh, Radibo Koshata, let things begin. Oh, Redeemer, let things begin. Where we will be saved to be the founders in the name of Jesus Christ. We thank you. We bless you, we adore you, we honor you, we give you praises. Somebody lift up your hands, lift up your beautiful, holy hands to the Lord. Tell him, Lord, make me, make me, make me, make me a repairer of breach. Oh Lord, I thank you. I thank you when I give you praises as I lay these foundations, Lord. As I lay these foundations in my marriage, as I lay these foundations in my family, as I lay these foundations in my ministry, in our church, dear Father, let your name be exalted. Let your name be glorified. Let your name be magnified in the name of Jesus Christ. And the Bible says, after you have been able to do all that, after all that has been declared and granted in your life, then you be called, and you shall be called. Somebody read with me that part C. And you shall be called the repairer of the breach, the restorer of the streets to dwell in. Now I want you to pray for yourself. Open up your mouth and tell the Lord, Help me to be found in my place. Oh, help me to be always in my place. In the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, Redeemer, enable me. Enable me. Enable me. Enable me. Let your authority that permits restoration, my Father, abide upon me. In the name of Jesus Christ. I pray, King of all glory, that you crown us, dear Master, with the crown of repairing. With the crown of repairing. Somebody pray that you will receive a crown of repairing. That you receive a crown. Women will run to you before they decide to leave their marriages. Where men will run before they decide to let go their wives. Where children will run to, or before anything they desire to do will happen in their lives. Lift up your voice. Tell the Lord, crown me as a repairer. I now know. I understand. Crown me as a repairer. I want to solve issues in families. I want to solve issues in the businesses. I want to address matters, oh God, in the lives of men and women. Oh, Redeemer, I want to counsel young people with your wisdom. I want to counsel, oh yes, marriages with your wisdom. I refuse to just best weddings, but as I best those weddings, Lord, I'll have what it takes to be called a spiritual parent in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, Redeemer, crown me. Crown me, Lord. Enable me. Energize me. Energize me. Renew my strength. Oh, Rikamashende Reboya. Ikozoto Robosika. Rada Bashekete. Yakaramayete Boro. Oh, Rakazoto Robida. Lift up your voice. Tell the Lord, I want to stand as an influencer. I want to stand as an influencer. I want to influence people unto good works of God. I want to influence people unto good works of Christ. I want to influence people unto good works of Jesus Christ. Oh, Redeemer, I want to be an influencer of godliness in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh God, I refuse to wait and watch as things get ruined. In the name of Jesus, I'll stand in my place. I'll stand in my place. I refuse to watch families. I refuse to watch churches break out. I refuse to see church breaking. Oh, Redeemer, stand in my place as a repairer, as a repairer, and I'll be able to point and say, I am the person behind the standing of that brother. I am the person behind the establishment of this sister. I am the person behind the prosperity and the wealth of my family. For I have stayed in my place. I have refused to forsake my place as a repairer, as a repairer, as a repairer. In the name of Jesus Christ, I worship you, Lord. I give you praises. I give you honor. I give you glory. Hey!
Yes to your will, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Somebody lift up your voice. Lift up your hands to the Lord. Open up your mouth. Say, I bring down every limitation. I bring down every limitation in the name of Jesus Christ. I bring down every opposing power to what the Lord wants to do with me in the name of Jesus Christ. I bring down every establishment that is not godly in my life. I bring down in the name of Jesus Christ every foundation that is not of God in my life, every plant that the Lord Oh, ina makazo torobo shekete ya karapo sikataya rekezita rabo shendeba aramazika taya robo. Open up your mouth, lift up your hands, lift up your hands to the Lord, lift up your hands, say I am a winner, I am a conqueror, I am a victor, I have been made a repairer, and for sure I am going to repair in the name of Jesus Christ. Therefore I cannot be repairing people's lives and my life stay in ruins. Hey, I want you to say are it cannot be that I'm repairing lives of my brothers and sisters when I am a beggar. It cannot happen. It cannot happen. I refuse that injustice in the name of Jesus Christ. I refuse that injustice. Hey, lift up your voice and refuse something in the realm of the spirit. Refuse something in the realm of the spirit. In the name of Jesus Christ, I cannot take that. I will not take anything less than what the Lord has ordained of me. In the name of Jesus Christ, I am a heir of divinity. I am a heir of godliness. Hey, we are the seed of Abraham, somebody. You are the seed of Abraham. Lift up your voice and declare, I am the seed of Abraham. I am a seed of Abraham. Hey, the enemy has no power over me. The enemy has no power over me. I have been chosen. I have been bought with a price. I have been bought with a price. Am I hearing you? Am I hearing you? I have been bought. I have been bought with a price.
With a price.
With a price. Somebody, you have been bought with a price. And that's why the Lord is entrusting all this unto us. That's why the Lord has entrusted all this unto you. For he has bought you. Karo pazeketa. Rakuma no sadiba rosa tekebo. Kamuka ya taro posha dabari. Mandila kasobro kaye repozete. Hera makashinda baya. Rema no kosipa razotokoye. Inda rabosha da. I know who I am in the Lord. I know who I am in the Lord. I am a child of the Most High God. Hey, I operate under the influence of the Holy Spirit. I am not carnal. I am not carnal. Somebody lift up your voice and declare, I am not carnal. I am not carnal. Hey, I am under an influence. I am under an influence. Somebody, you are under an influence. The influence of the Holy Spirit. Peter told them, yes, it is true, we are drunk. As you may perceive, as you are perceiving, it is true. It is true. I want you to look at the person standing with you. Tell them, as you can see, yes, it is true. As you can see, yes, it is true. I am drunk. I am not at myself. Hey, you are correct. Tell somebody, you are correct.
You are correct.
Your judgment is correct.
Your judgment
what you are seeing, truly it is so.
Truly it is.
Yes.
It is so.
I am not sober.
I am not sober.
I am not sober.
I am not sober.
I am under an influence.
I am under
an influence. Peter told them. But not as you suppose. But the fact of being drunk, we are not denying. The fact that we are blessed, we are not denying. The fact that we are under an influence, we are not denying. But not as you suppose. It is by the influence of the Holy Ghost. Of the Holy Ghost. For the things of the Spirit may look nonsensical to the carnal man, but when you ascend, oh, the place that I am operating from, my brother, my sister, you'll be able to have an experience, and you will understand, why is she jumping like this? Why is she walking like this? You will understand, where is this boldness coming from? Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Days of mourning are ended. Days of crying are ended. Days of self-pity are ended.
Yes.
Come on, somebody. Days of this drama. Lazima kubadilike. Hey! Nani alisema? Lazima ikue hivi na hivi na hivi. Kisha sasa ikue sawa. Nani alisema? Now that was not consulted. That's why I have come to put things in order. In the name of Jesus Christ. Eti kwetu lazima kukue na mtu amepagawa. Solo kango madhei ni waretu wale achesu. Hey! I bring down that satanic order. In the name of Jesus Christ. Lazima wakiolewa watoke. Mara ya kwanza na ya pili kisha ya tatu wakae. Nani alisema hivyo? Ni wakati wa kudemolish. It is time to demolish. Hey, my sister, don't wait until your marriage has issues. It is time to start gangale. It is time to invade and tell the enemy, I have watched your patterns. I have watched your manner of life. Hey, but I want to tell you, this is a new generation. This is a royal priesthood.
Oh, yes.
This is an anointed one. Things must change. You are not closing this line.
Oh, yes.
Hey, sorerango mara imi. Mwere durabe tukaba. Durabe tukaba. Ni okite mono. Umefanya sana. Umejaribu sana. Tumekuruhusu sana. Hey, this time round, there is a new introduction. This kite. This kite. There is a new introduction. Oh, are you feeling like me? Tell him there is a new introduction.
A new
you have not seen this kite. But now, here it is. Sent of the Lord.
Yes.
As a repair.
Oh.
Give a celebration.
Hallelujah.
To Jesus. I want us to celebrate our viewers. Thank you for staying tuned.
Hallelujah.
We love you, we love you, we love you, we love you.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Let's give a celebration as we usher in our
Hallelujah.
Mama.
Hallelujah. Hey.
Hallelujah. Yeah. Praise the name of Jesus. We have been given divinity in us. And that is what is enabling us to be restorers. That is what is enabling us to rebuild the ruins. Hallelujah. No more waste places. For the Lord has raised us. Yes, the Lord has raised you. Bwana asifiwe. You know, God is not expecting you to pray that things will be made well. God is not expecting you to pray and call him so that he can come and straighten the crooked ways. God is not waiting for you. You know, gaindara expecti omwite. Nigetha oke, riu athondeke maundu. Maundu asu makuthondekwa. Maundu asu magwikwa me iguru yaku weo. Nikiore to rebuilder. Nikiore to restorer. Hallelujah. Todo kai agutuite gakai. There are things that God will never pay attention because he has raised you. So activate divinity in you so that you can be able to be a rebuilder. Kazomayande rapo shakata. He has entrusted you with that is able